It's too early to predict where a caravan of several thousand migrants will end its journey. But with midterm elections here and troops stationed along the U.S. Mexico border, Texas residents have been drawn into debate on what defines a crisis and what values define them.
I feel like we're welcoming to others, and that's what I like about El Paso.
Family and cultural ties unite residents of West Texas, New Mexico, and Ciudad Juarez in Mexico. Where the neighboring communities meet, an annual border mass serves to remember those who have perished seeking refuge. Residents here say they will be ready should the caravan arrive in their city.
They're preparing shelters. People are supporting with food, clothing, with coats, because the cold season is coming.
We know what they're living over there. We know what they're experiencing. They know how they live. They know what they're going through. So when we receive them over here, say, oh, sure.
El Paso holds claim to the safest city in Texas and seventh overall in the U.S. Though in a reliably Democratic county, local supporters of President Trump's efforts to fortify the border and deter the caravan from touching U.S. soil make a case similar to immigration hardliners elsewhere in the country.
If it's 7,000, what prevents them from bringing on another 7,000 and another 7,000? We have to draw a line as to where and how we want to let people in the country.
The dwindling caravan is now less than half that number, but Aldo Cole thinks the troops are a small price to pay for security.
They're making it seem like people are coming with guns and stuff, and there's no way they would come with guns, but we don't know what we're getting, right? And so they should have respect for the country they're coming into, just as every day when I go to work in Mexico, I have respect for their country.
How you guys doing? Fine, we came down to visit the wall.
President Trump has invoked national security in describing the caravan of would-be asylum seekers trekking through danger in the Gulf Coast state of Veracruz, Mexico. But some longtime residents here call the president's actions and rhetoric a smokescreen ahead of Tuesday's midterm elections that could provide a check on his authority.
Unless two countries get together, two neighbors, try and get together to solve the problem by insulting them and by putting another fence next to theirs and doing all this stuff, that's not going to help it. You're not going to help anybody.
Ana Perez, a Tigua tribal member of Isleta del Sur Pueblo in Texas, cites the long history of her own sovereign nation.
Not only my nation, but many other Native American nations have been dishonored for centuries. You know, here, we have been here over 300 years on this land. So therefore, why would we feel threatened by someone else?
Ramon Taylor, VOA News, El Paso, Texas.